Yeah, I think you're over here.
Hey, hey, hey. Oh, hello. Hi, I didn't see you there. Hey, how many people are seeing Night Attack for the first time ever? All right, three of you. Good. Everyone else?
Yeah, there's a couple of people lying. I can see their liar hands.
And you're not one of you.
Look way taller than me. I am
so shocked you gave me the tall seat.
I didn't.
Like, that is the biggest upset of the evening.
I was assigned. Hey, Katrina, can we trade seats?
No, I mean not that you would be on stage, but that I would be slightly taller.
Can you co-host the show? Do you just want to switch? You can just switch seats.
No,
switch seats. Go, go, go.
Okay, yes, that totally.
Oh my
if you
God!
Insist.
Twist your arm.
All right.
Oh Jesus!
Fuck it!
Fuck it! All right.
Okay.
All right. Do we want to set this up?
No. Okay. All right. So tell everyone about the Will Harris thing.
So, how many people, listeners to the show, know who Will Harris is?
All right. Was it GQ's most eligible bachelors or something? One of those.
Yeah, it was some. Yeah,
he's Condé Nast publication.
Shocking. So he's a great friend, of course, to the show, and a brilliant human being. And he decided to write down our poor synopsis of
a made up. Okay, so if you guys watched last week's episode, we played a game where we had to describe Oscar movies we hadn't seen, and one of them was Hell or High Water. So we decided it was the story of a mattress salesman named Hell or High Water, and we made up a really dumb story, which sounds dumb out of our mouths while we're saying it, but when somebody writes it down,
yeah,
and then feeds it back to you by an audio file recorded in the style of a Rick and Morty alternate universe trailer, it was a surreal moment.
So this is a British person doing an impression of Justin Roiland improvising a movie using the words that we were using to improvise a movie.
The exact words.
So here we go. This is Hell or High Water.
He's a mattress salesman in Peoria. A man has he got it raw. His wife is just cheating on him all the time, and she's just like, "Hella, I'm fucking everybody in this town." And he goes, "Hey, man, I'm Hella Highwater. You don't talk to me that way, dame." And then he just like sits down. He sits down and cries, and that's pretty much the movie. But at the end though, there's the big ending where he sells the mattress, but it's a big celebrity cameo from Johnny Depp, but he's doing a voice. I'm Johnny Depp, and I'd like to buy a mattress now.
Yeah. Oh, I don't know, Rick. It feels like movies in this dimension kind of have more of an improvisational feel. You know what I mean?
All right. The adorable Will Harris, ladies and gentlemen.
Let's get a round of applause.
So when you played that for me, I went through three layers. You said, hey, man.
Well, number one, he just texted it to me today.
Right.
He just was like, hey, do you watch Rick and Morty? And I'm like, sure. And then he just texted me a sound file.
Well, and so he's like, he said, I hear, Will Harris sent this to me, and he starts playing it, and I hear it. And I'm like, oh, he's doing an impression of Rick and Morty. And I'm like, but this is a dumb bit.
And then
that realization that those are our words reflected through the funhouse mirror of the Brito himself. All right, I'm getting the high sign. I think it's time to start the show. Is that right?
All right,
here we go. Are you guys ready to start the show?
You ready?
Holy shit, beautiful people, live from PAX South, or nearby it. It's Night Attack. Bringing you the best of the worst of the internet ever since anyone cared. Hey, I'm Brian Brushwood. Nobody cares. And Justin Robert Young. All right, still nobody cares.
Still nobody.
Yeah, see, we're at this mushy middle. I mean, number one, it's a miracle that this happened, considered that we invested 20 minutes in a taco. But number two, the fact, like, we got a great turnout here for what we expected. We just wanted to record live and wanted one person, and instead we got 20.
Yeah. No, it's great. Thank you all for coming. Man, we, you know, it's a good thing that horse shit is infinite and that we can keep making more of it, because We literally did a show like 48 hours ago, and now we are here. But you want to know what? We are going to get through this thanks to a lot of very talented people.
At audible.com.
Yeah.
No, sorry.
Well, did you want to go over some of the stuff that we were talking about today?
Yeah.
What did you want to talk about?
Hold on. I wrote it down because I didn't want
to. You didn't want to forget it. This is very important, folks. We know that need to make sure that we're bringing it here.
I wrote these things down. I wrote down Jeep, which I think was a reference to us driving down in the Jeep and me picking you up in the Jeep and you being angry that when I picked you up at the airport in the Jeep, I wasn't blasting Ba Wa Ta Ba. Instead, I just turned on the 90s station and turned it to whatever.
Well, yeah. Like, he's like, oh, I was trying to figure out what the perfect song would be to pick you up in the Jeep in. And I'm like, do you not know how to spell Ba Wa Ta Ba?
But the real thing was I chickened out. Like, I'm sitting there and it's short and I'm just like, I can't. Like, I can do it for 30 seconds and then peel out and be like, so long, fuckos.
I know.
But I can't do it in that slow grind, that meatpacking conveyor belt of just like, I can't stop and start for 15 goddamn minutes as my car creeps along blasting and I have to make eye contact with every cop reject who's running on the TSA and telling me to blow forward. Blow forward? I'm in a boat.
I really wanted you to be in the cell phone lot of the Austin International Airport, and you start playing Ba Wa Ta Ba, and then you're like halfway there when it ends, and you have to make the
I have to hit repeat.
Uncomfortable decision, where it's just like, ba-da-da-da-da-da. Repeat.
All right, I also wrote down, sideburns, because I got a haircut while you were on DTNS today, mm-hmm. and getting a haircut in another country, city, is a weird thing, because I needed it very badly, so I just opened it, found the nearest one, looked at Yelp, it was 5 stars, went in, hipster as hell, they got a bar, they immediately sat me down, and they're like, you want a shot? and they open up a
mini
fridge.
So do you think that they offer everybody a shot? Or just looked at you in the face and they're like, this dude will take free liquor and it doesn't matter what it is.
I mean, if they did, they also had a time machine and set everything up in advance, because I walked in and he opened up a mini fridge and I had a choice between a shot of Jameson, a shot of Crown Royal, a Coronita, the tiny Corona bottles, who just said, aw. And a Bud Light.
But they all had Brian's name on it.
So which of those four do you think I picked for my haircut? Because the answer wasn't no, obviously.
Okay. I think I really want you to get
there's
the
There's a murmur in the crowd.
Yeah, everybody's discussing. I think it's the shot of Jamie.
No. See, that would say, I am a hardcore alcoholic. And so instead, I wanted a beer, but I'm like, man, I'm going to get a Bud Light in a place like this. So I took the Coronita.
Oh, damn it. Damn it.
And so I sat there with a Coronita.
Go to the pay window, everybody who had Coronita. Now collecting.
And so I told him, here's the question I have for you. Because, do the haircut, and it's like, I never know how to describe how I want my haircut. So I always open up, I Google my name, and then
you son of a bitch.
And then...
You son of a bitch. You don't even have the common courtesy to save a picture that you previously Googled.
Well, because...
You need to make them wallow in your fame to let you know that you are a big shot.
Okay, but here's the problem. It's like I have...
Oh, look, I'm the first result. You know, just breaking the ice.
Well, and so the problem is I don't want I don't want what my last haircut looks like. I want the way it looked when I was on Foolus. And so. So anyway, I show him my Twitter avatar, and I'm trying. This is as cool as I'm able to play. I'm like something like this. Less is more, and then I realize I've painted myself in a corner because I have to say because I have a shoot and I have this shoot thing and get started and by the way, he did the smartest move I've ever seen of any barber ever. He
shut you up with a Coronita.
He started cutting my hair and then turned the chair around away from the mirror. I had never done that. Have you ever experienced that where they cut your entire hair and didn't let you see how it was going?
I don't know. I don't know the magic I don't know the magic of barbers. Like, I don't know if they would, like, I know you need to walk outside. Like, I would. Like they can just tell me what to do, and I'll do it.
Well, and so I found myself, anyway, I was in that awkward position where it's like, I was like, all right, I'm going to own this. And so it's like I told them all about, you know, blah, 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 and doing the stage show and what we're up to next week and stuff. And then and he's like, wait, what's that? And
I had to run down your entire resume?
Well, there's a long time when he keeps asking you, well, what do you mean? By shoot.
Yeah.
Magic? What kind of magic?
So I started working at Dell, and my wife gave me 1 year to make magic a career.
God damn it. All right, so at any rate, so here's the awkward part, and this is the secret. You gave a fine haircut, but they always ask, how do you want your sideburns? And of course, I wear the perpetual, you know, 20-minute scruff that grown-ups are able to grow, and so I'm like, well, I always say, like, it doesn't matter. I mean, it's going to eventually become this beard thing or whatever, right? And he's like, so rounded, square? I'm like, I don't know, blended, I guess? He's like, okay. And I get the haircut and everything's great and I go home or I go to your place, pick you up or whatever. It is not until I go to the bathroom like an hour ago that I look in the mirror and realize when shaping my sideburns, he shaved underneath the sideburns. So I have one of those I'm shaved and my beard starts below my cheek things.
No, yeah. No, no.
Happening.
Right now, for only audio listeners, there would be a little evil Knievel that would have to make the jump from
the
his side
canyon
down to his beard.
I've never worn
that. That's a little Snake River Canyon Brian's next to his ear hole.
I'm very uncomfortable with it. That's my whole point, is that it feels very awkward and I can't wait until
next week. Hold
when
on,
it grows
wait a minute.
In.
What's more uncomfortable? If I, like, just rub it?
No, that's actually pretty good.
Is that good?
We ran into old ladies.
It's a woo for old ladies?
On the way in. On the way in, Bryce and I went and grabbed the stuff.
Yeah.
So we walk all the way over to the parking lot.
Before you even tell the story, all I imagine is just, like, you know, you pull up and all of a sudden, like, it's a 1980s beer commercial. It's just like a Camaro pulls up with a bunch of old ladies in it.
I pull down my sunglasses.
It's just a polka version of Van Halen's Beautiful Girls.
So, okay. So
funnier if you think about it.
I went over and got this. We got the stuff, and so we're lugging all this crap. It is very clearly sound equipment in the backpack and all that stuff. And so we get into the elevator, and we're only going down one floor. And then there's, like, this one lady who walks up and then stops because she sees us with gear. And Bryce is like, oh, no, there's room. Come on in. And she goes, well, I have a friend. And she goes, that's fine. And then she gets in, and she's like, well, there's actually a few of us. So we're like, oh. And so we squeeze into the back.
Yeah.
And so, like, four adorable old ladies get in. And all of them, you know, it's like you get – it's the four Golden Girls, right? So picture, like, one's got the spiky hair, like, I don't give a fuck anymore. One's got the wacky hat.
Jesus.
No. Like, but at any rate, so they walk in and we're friendly and they're friendly and they're like, oh, so what did she say? She said, are you with the band or are you the band? And so again, faced with Sophie's Choice, I say, oh, actually we do a comedy show. Actually, it's Bryce who outed us. He goes, we do a comedy. Oh, he said yes. He said yes. He said yes.
Basically, we're looking at every road that leads to explaining how famous you are. There's just a million ways to get to explaining that you're a very big deal.
Well, okay, so there's this moment they said, are you with the, are you the band? And then Bryce goes, yes, we're the band. And then I'm like, I mean, actually, it's a comedy show. And then I realize what I've done. And she turns and she goes, oh, tell me a joke. And the doors are closed and we're now trapped for that 15 seconds. And I realize, like, oh shit.
Do you have to tell a joke now?
Yes, exactly. And I'm like, do I even know a joke? And so, like, I just tell the truth. I'm like, we just pretty much say poop over and over. And then they all laugh. And then the door opens. And then I say out loud, I guess that was a joke. Because it made them laugh.
So anyway, old ladies, I said poop too.
You said poop over and over again.
All right.
And there we go. I'll tell you what.
Hold on. We made up a song about the Riverwalk.
No, we're not going to talk about the song about the Riverwalk.
Come up to me after the show.
Yeah,
you want to talk about Maggie Smith's butthole?
Oh, so you have your butthole is Maggie Smith.
It is?
But we have to talk about that with our guests. Ladies and gentlemen, let's go ahead and welcome on right now. You know them from, of course, Movies with Mikey and the brand newly minted co-host of the Star Wars show, Mikey Neumann and Anthony Carboni!
Yeah!
You guys are over here.
Hello.
We're gonna mix up these mics.
What's up, San Antonio? I've been here for 2 hours and my skin's dry as fuck already.
Wait, you're from...
very normal. Just a normal boy.
My finger skin is flaking like perfectly
you're standing
cooked fish
on,
sticks.
Yeah, okay.
Are you ready for this?
You're at a 9 and I love it.
Dude.
I love it.
This is like a 6.5.
Hey, Anthony, real quick. I assume there's one person in our whole audience who doesn't know what you do with the Star Wars show. Can you real quick?
Because it just happened
sure.
5 minutes ago.
Well, it's got a really complicated title, so people probably can't figure it out through context.
Yeah.
It is a show about Star Wars.
Yeah.
But it's actually the official Lucasfilm show about Star Wars. We host it from the Lucasfilm compound in San Francisco.
Dude.
And it's all the newest Star Wars news, interviews.
Dude.
I'm a very big deal, sir.
I know.
I'm a very big
deal,
sir.
Just wait until you get your next haircut. I hear that's the time that you can really blow it up.
The guy's cutting my hair. It's like, have you ever seen Star Wars? I'm sorry. I'm tangentially related to it.
Did you just make a joke about Anthony's haircut? Because the entire audience is like, no, they have the exact same fucking hair across the board.
We're a type.
It's
only
like
the difference
no,
is
it's a spectrum.
I
we're
cut
like going
my
down
own
a spectrum
hair.
Of like haircut.
Hey, so seriously, do you run into Chewbacca at work?
No. We have Chopper. We have the actual like droid. We have Chopper at work. We got a mouse droid at work, a functioning mouse droid.
Yeah.
We have 3PO at work, but it doesn't work unless Anthony Daniels actually comes inside.
So anyway, I also work at Star Wars.
Also, Mikey is cool too.
I actually am Chewbacca. Hello.
There are 3 YouTube channels that I can get my wife to watch with me.
That's a good Chewbacca noise, right?
And one of them is Chainsaw Suit because she loves movies with Mikey.
Yeah.
Oh, wow.
Who loves movies with Mikey?
Yeah.
That's very kind. The next movies of Mikey is just going to be like just over and over.
Damn it. Somebody just
handed us. Oh, and shots. And
twins.
I'm fine.
All right. So Captain Morgan it is, I assume. Oh, geez. It's actually
Captain John.
By the way, that was handed to us by the Patreon saint himself, Time Jumper.
Round of applause for Time Jumper. Well, hey, guys. Thank you so much for coming on the show here tonight.
Of course. Mm. Thank you for having us. I'm just sitting right in front of this fucking PA.
It's just feedback forever.
How long is this cord?
There we go.
Yeah. What if I went over here?
Just go over there.
What if I went over here?
That's the way to go.
There we go. Hey, so... real quick. This is my first...
Just real quick.
Tangential.
Just real quick.
We got a lot of ground.
Number
to
one,
cover.
Do you know
can
that
you
he's going on a
quick?
Shoot?
God damn it. In all seriousness, I've never been in PAX South, and I won't be able to go to PAX South. This is the closest I'll ever get to PAX South. You did PAX South before. You're doing it at PAX South for the first time, right?
No, this is my third one.
I am
the OG here.
Mikey's not local, but you're close.
Dallas,
right?
Dallas.
I don't know how a Texas works.
It just keeps going as it turns out.
just imagine.
You may be farther away from San Antonio than I am. I don't understand geography or time.
He's pretty much a longer, almost as long a drive as yours would be to commute to work.
No, it makes sense. Don't worry. Look it up on Google Maps. These are all the best jokes I've proven
get out
on
a
Google
whiteboard.
Maps. Yeah.
they were good attempts at jokes. I give you guys effort for trying.
All right.
Wow.
But
wow.
Okay, but hold on. I thought this was your first Movies with Mikey as a panel. That's not the case.
No, yes, that is true. I'm doing the first live Movies with Mikey Saturday, 6:30 in Falcon Theater.
Who's going to be there for that? Is everybody going to that?
Oh, hey, there's people that like stuff. That's cool. Yeah. That's new.
And so how do you take the... Because the Movies with Mikey experience is very tight and chopped and edited together.
So here's why I'm the dumbest person alive. I actually am doing that live.
Oh, wait.
I built a presentation that I will run through while talking, and I'm editing it in real time.
Yeah, it's just going to be him, like, slowly scrubbing to the exact point in which he's...
Well, it's a lot
getting up,
it's a lot simpler.
Taking a piss, you know.
Lot simpler than that, but yeah. I put together a presentation that I talk over and run through.
Have you revealed what movie you're reviewing?
No, so that was the thing. I thought it would be really funny if I did an episode of Movies with Mikey about Movies with Mikey.
About how famous you are.
Yeah, about how famous I am. Yeah. Brian Brushwood, star of Discovery Channel and other things. No, I thought it would be funny to do an ironic dissection of the show, and what I found out was...
Are you going to make us cry at the end for how good your show is?
Maybe. I did actually have some realizations of my own about my own show, and I was like, oh shit, I didn't know why I was doing that, and now I do know... And it was very weird.
You tricked yourself into self-reflection for once.
I movies with Mikey myself, and I was like, is that what that feels like? I don't like it. I'm not good with that.
I wonder what it would be like if you were Mystery Science Theatering your own life as it happened.
I feel like
Joel Hodgson does that. I would like it if this forever changed you, and now you were just like the show was different. You were different. You had different hair.
Yeah,
you would, like,
I'm no longer funny. I only eat lizards.
Yeah,
it's
mostly a lizard-based diet.
It's the South lizard diet.
Yeah, you only have to catch them free range though, or else it doesn't count. No store-bought lizards.
My bar is Central Market lizards and up. which does include Market Street. I got you, baby birds. You can eat lizards from there. It's fine.
All right. So the moment we did not ask him to do this, but basically we put out the bat signal for all our favorite people at PAX, and we're like, hey, you're awesome people. We're gonna do a night attack, and we know it'll be easy if awesome friends show up. And four of them said, three said yes, one said no. And two showed up, so that's not bad. Now,
that is very good.
Again, I tell you, I had okay. So Mikey and I have only ever communicated via DM.
This is also the first time we've ever met.
We have only communicated via DM, and we've hung out like a million times. But I didn't recognize his number, and so what happened is like you were, hey, we're gonna do a live night attack, and the number I didn't recognize goes, oh, can I put together a quiz? I was like, oh, that's Mikey's number. Mikey's number now.
You know the worst part of this story? I actually saved your number in my phone, and I think you did not save my number in your phone.
Wow.
Carboni's
getting this booed. Man.
Well, that explains why we've only ever talked by DM.
It's fine.
I've been like, I don't have Mikey's number, so I just DM you.
I think Star Wars changes a man.
Yeah. I'm very important now. Very important.
So Mikey made a quiz, and normally we play this as a two-player operation, but I think we could do three teams, and we'll just rotate who has to go first.
What would make my night easier if someone could keep score? Because I don't want to.
How about the internet?
Can I give you a pen and a pad?
Yeah. All right. Who's going to be our official?
There we go.
Saved.
No, where the pen is, I already wrote everybody's names down. You'll notice that Jury is listed as Jummy because that's my favorite thing in the world.
All right.
This is a 10-question quiz.
By the way, you're welcome to walk across. This is not important.
Yeah,
don't worry about it.
All right. So for audio listeners, we are literally blocking.
Could you just wait for like 27 to 35 minutes? Just hold on. Just we're almost done.
I like that you gave a
wide
band 27 to 35. So on Night Attack, I often quiz these two dumbos with really irrelevant dumb shit. And
yeah. Man,
I thought, what better way to go through the weekend than to put together the most diabolical quiz ever?
Which, by the way, for the first time, I believe, on the show, you pre-tested to get feedback.
I did. I pre-tested it on my friend who knows me very well and metagamed it. He only got 5 out of 10.
So that's the baseline.
And he had a freebie. So to jump into this, the title of this quiz is Bad 1980s Action Movies and the User Submitted IMDb Descriptions That Explain Their Plot.
How fucking dare you?
That explain their plot or don't. So what I have done, just to explain
or
it,
don't.
I took the most low-budget, horrible 1980s action movies, grabbed their titles, found their IMDb reviews and plot synopses from crowdsourcing.
Yeah.
Which is very bad, and they cannot write words or grammar.
Right.
And then I wrote fake ones in, using and utilizing their terrible grammar.
Yeah.
Fake ones in.
And now you must all guess if the thing I'm talking about is real or fake.
All right.
My lovely assistant will be keeping score. What's your name, by the way? Sorry.
Tess.
Tess will be keeping score.
Thank you, Tess.
All at once. Here we go. On three. One, two, three.
Thank you, Tess.
Thank you, Auntie Donna.
All right, wait.
Before we get into this, because Carboni, just his world fell from his face as soon as this topic was mentioned. Do you feel confident about guessing the veracity of these 1980s movies?
So, am I guessing that the movie is real? Am I guessing that the review is real?
There's two situations. Either the movie is real, and this is the actual IMDb synopsis as submitted by the IMDb community. Or this is all horseshit. So basically,
or Mikey made it
up. It's like, all gonna be true.
Or it's Mikey's horseshit.
All true or all fake.
Gotcha.
But luckily, I got to write.
I feel okay about it.
You won't in about five minutes.
I'm sure I won't. I have a really inflated sense of self, so I feel pretty good about everything.
No.
Dude. Yeah. Fucking. That's how you know you got a mark.
I'm pretty confident about everything.
He comes marching in. I can't be fooled.
All right,
take it away.
Let's go.
So the way we're going to do this is going to start with Jummy. It's going to go around to Anthony on the first question. Then it'll start with Brian.
Roger.
Go back around to Jummy and so on and so forth.
Roger.
All right.
Jury, you are first.
Let's go.
Here is the title and description as described by IMDb. Is this a real or fake movie from the 1980s? Here we go.
All right.
The name of the movie is Hell Comes to Frogtown. And the synopsis, Hell is the name of the hero of the story. He's a prisoner of the woman who now runs the USA after a nuclear/biological war. Results of the war are the mutants have evolved and the human race is in danger of extinction because of infertility. Hell is given the task, by the way, Hell is the main character. Hell is given the task of helping in the rescue of a group of fertile women from the harem of the mutant leader and parenthetically listed after of the mutant leader resembling a frog is in parentheses. So is that a real 1980s B action film, Jummy, or is that a fake?
Well, you did it this time, Mikey.
You have no idea how bad this gets.
Well, I'm glad our baseline is total incoherence. I am going to say that is a real 1980s.
Brian Brushwood.
Movie. All right. I am thinking that the odds that this is a real movie and the odds that we made up a movie called Hell or High Water are extraordinarily low.
We didn't make up the fact that there's a movie called Hell or High Water.
Right.
Yeah, no, that's still nominated for actual Academy Awards. Yeah. You troglodytes.
Okay, all right.
But didn't watch it or know what it was.
No. Okay.
But all right.
But we made it a character named Hell. So I'm gonna
Heller.
I'm gonna say that's gotta be fake.
All right, we got a real and a fake.
It's
Anthony.
Real. I've seen Hell Comes to Frogtown.
Really?
Yeah. Because they would show it on USA and Cinemax, and there's a part with sexy ladies dancing, and I was like 10 years old. I've seen the original Frogtown and Hell Comes
to Frogtown. Anthony Carboni called it. That is 1 point to Jummy and 1 point to the Carbonzo.
Yeah.
Oh, put a it back in your pants. Like, we just started.
Hey, like, everybody at the door, make sure to let everybody new know that they're welcome to just cross in front of us.
Come on in.
Doesn't matter. All right, go for it.
What if we give them, like, theme music, like, boop, boop, doo, 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 as they walk? Okay, number two. No,
that's a great song.
Number two.
In fact, that's the official theme song. We gesture for them to go across, and then all of us
together. So anybody listening at home.
Boop, 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 boop.
Is that just the Power Rangers theme song?
Yeah, I was about to say that.
It's a copyright. It's like a copyright free off-key version.
No, that's pretty exactly it.
Yeah.
No, you got it. It's in a minor key.
Yeah, that's
minor
like the communicator. Yeah. All
right. I'm just glad that we're more proud of the Power Rangers theme song than the new Power Rangers movie that apparently is like, you know, going to be as serious as Chandler's.
Let's get back on topic here, guys.
All right, Roger that.
Number two, starting.
And the topic is the use of Kanye West's power in the trailer for reboots of 90s preteen television shows.
Sure.
Because I can talk a lot about that.
All right. We are going to start with Brian on this one. Number
two. So we're going off topic.
Is this a real 1980s shitty action movie or not?
All right.
The title is 2156. What would you not pay for in without the price of freedom? If Duke Alex knows, then people are about to die. The year is 2156. Yeah, you said that already, movie. Everyone is about to die. Can Duke Alex play Russian roulette with the neon cops, or will he lose it all? Brian Brushwood.
My favorite part about this is that if Mikey gets too drunk, it doesn't matter.
Can I get confirmation? The title is just 2156?
The title is just the year 2156.
All right, gotcha. And which year does this take place in?
2156.
Okay. I'm going to say this is real. It's too bad. It's too...
You already said real. We're moving on.
False.
No.
I'm saying false.
No.
You're more dumb. Go.
I am going to say... Normally, I just have to look at your Skype window. I can look into your cold, dead eyes. That's false.
It is false?
Yeah!
All right.
Oh, I'm feeling good now. I got my mojo back.
I am so glad Chris Straub has showed up.
I used to listen to a lot of Chainsaw Soup podcasts, and I know that the first couple of these are all about a false sense of security.
Oh, nope, yeah. Wrong. Number three.
This is head games.
Which starts with Anthony Carboni. Yeah. And listen to the whole thing before you react.
All right.
The title of the film is Blade Crammer.
I'm sorry, hold on. Blade Crammer.
One word.
Blade Crammer.
Blade Crammer.
So lowercase c. Lowercase c.
Is it about Edgar Blade Crammer?
Excuse me. The synopsis is as follows.
It's about a shipwright in the 1800s. Edgar Blade Crammer.
Yep.
I will say, laugh now and listen, because the year is 20 years later.
Oh, after 2166.
The Earth, excuse me, it's very serious.
So it's 2176.
The Earth is run by corporations who only crave oil. This satirical look at sci-fi movies like Voyagers or Blade Runner will have you rolling in the aisles begging for more.
Is that
Blade Crammer.
Blade Crammer.
Blade Crammers.
We're starting with me?
God, how much?
Blade Crammer is false.
Wait. Didn't you just go first?
No.
You just did. Okay, he just went.
He said fake.
He says S or a Z in Blade Crammers.
Oh, I thought it was singular.
It's S. It's just Blade Crammers, like spelled
Just Blade Superman. Crammer. A singular Blade Crammer.
Crammers.
Blade Crammers.
No Z.
S. Okay, got you.
How many exclamation points?
None.
How many NAs?
What's the font?
I'm going to say that's also false.
I'm going to say it's real.
Wrong again, Brian Brushwood.
God damn it.
No! How's your shoot now?
Damn, dog. All right. Number four.
How come your sideburns don't go all the way down to your beard, dummy?
I guess that's where you hit all your trivia knowledge.
He shaved off your... It turns out I'm the Samson of Mikey's quizzes. And he cut off the
one part.
It was
only in the beard connector.
All unimportant trivia is kept in the mutton chop portion of the face.
And he cut it off, and I've lost my ability.
All right.
Number four, starting with Jummy.
Jody.
Time Rider, The Adventures of Lyle Swan. That's the title. An officially dead cop is trained to become an extraordinarily unique assassin in service of the U.S. president. Lyle, a motorcycle champion, is traveling the Mexican desert when he finds himself in the action radius of a time machine. So he find himself one century back in the past between thieves and murderers.
Thieves is, how is thieves spelled?
Thieves, not thieves.
Okay, it's a Z and one exclamation point.
Got it.
And what was the title
there's
again?
There's actually a four in there. Yeah.
What was the title again?
Time Rider, colon, The Adventure of Lyle Swan.
Time Writer or Rider?
Time Writer, like I'm writing like, time. Like,
okay, gotcha.
Like it's a horse. Like all time right, is a right. horse in this hypothetical.
I'm going to say it's true.
Okay.
I swear I'm not doing this tactically, but I say it's true.
This is the first one that's actually confused me. Because this sounds, am I allowed to go into process a little bit?
Yep.
Absolutely. Absolutely.
This sounds a little bit like there was a period in the late 80s to early 90s where a lot of bad television pilots were released as films.
Movies. Yeah, or direct to video.
Yeah, as direct to video films.
I like your thought process.
Full Moon would put them out, or like Anchor Bay would put them out, or they would be on syndicated TV. You'd see them on WGN.
All right.
And this sounds like it could be the pilot episode. Of Time Rider. That's why I'm a little confused by this. However, right.
However,
it's just so garbage.
Yeah.
It's just so garbage. And the plot is just a little too disconnected from the title.
Yeah.
I think I'm going to go false.
So you go false, and we both went true.
I think we're going to go false. Right. This is where you and I part ways.
Indeed. We're going
to
find out who goes
false.
Hold on. Real quick.
Before we do.
Okay. Well, also, I factually know the answer to this one.
You do?
Because I fucking loved this movie when I was in second grade.
No!
Really?
Yeah. This dude goes back to the Old West, and it really is. He's riding his motorcycle along.
Really?
And there's an experiment happening, and it is super disjointed. And suddenly, and I'm like, is he a hero? Is he, because he's just kind of riding around a motorcycle in the Old West. And then meanwhile, like there was one scene that always creeped
me out. That's a bummer. My original gut was true and I went false.
I mean, I may have a false memory.
And I went false. And now, you're in the lead.
All right. Hey, Mikey, you're back from the bathroom.
I went false.
I revealed that I knew this one was true because it was one of my favorite movies on HBO when I was in second grade.
I was hoping somebody saw it. It was more popular. It is real.
And in Anthony's defense. Yeah.
I went true. I went real.
So 2 points to you guys, and you got boned.
Have you watched this movie, Mikey?
No.
Oh, man, there's this creepy-ass scene. Yeah, whatever, don't matter. Like, it was the first time I'd ever seen somebody strip a dead body for clothing.
Huh.
Right, so anyway.
But not the last.
Thank you for that fact.
All right.
We are now on you starting.
Roger, guys, go ahead. Yeah.
Number five. Is this a real 1980s action movie or not? The title is Thrill Kill, all one word. And the description is as follows. Carly Kendall's job is to write computer games, but in her spare time, she hacks bank accounts. With $5 million gathered, she wants to retire to Brazil, unaware that her secret partner, Adrian, intends to keep all the money. Moreover, Carly's boss, Julian, has got to know of her doing and has hired villains to get hold of the treasure. Only after Carly's death, they realize that she had hidden the money well inside the computer game Thrill Kill.
Brian?
I mean, it sounds like it's so on the nose, it can't possibly be true. But I want to say it's true,
because I feel like I remember the name Thrill Kill. But then again, that's the way this sucker works, yeah. Right? Is that he takes it? But I feel like the memory is strong enough, and that it's not a false memory that I'm gonna say it's real.
So, Thrill Kill does sound familiar, but that's because there was originally a game for the PlayStation that was called Thrill Kill that came back as the Wu-Tang fighting game. But
I think that might be what I was remembering.
But I also believe that I remember.
What a deep dig.
But I also believe that I remember this movie. I also believe that I've seen this movie, and so I'm going to say true.
Okay. Two truths.
Oh, the tactics. Do you agree, or do you separate yourself
one
and have the chance to break
ahead? One of us always tells the truth. Yeah. One of us always lies.
One of us always talks about how famous he is.
I am also going to say...
Don't let us peer pressure you.
This is true.
We don't need a fucking life story. Just pick an answer.
Well,
when I was young,
coming from.
When I was young, my father made computer games.
It's true.
When I was a young boy in the convent, the nuns showed me Thrill Kill. I don't know why.
All right. He says it's true. Yes,
all
true.
Correct.
One point
to all of them.
I mean,
I remember that movie because I remember being a kid and wanting it to be more about the video game.
You guys are doing very good, I think. What is the current score? 5 in?
Jummy has 5.
Come on up to the mic.
Come on up, Tess.
Jody.
Everybody, big round of applause for Tess.
Jummy has 5. Tony has 4. And Brian, with an M, has 2.
Ah, goddamn. The Samson.
I should have went with my cut on.
How you doing, Brian?
How am I supposed to win when I've been lobotomized? All my knowledge, all my skills. I'm like Superman when his powers got taken away. I don't know if that ever happened.
It's Superman 2.
Yeah, I'm like that.
Our next movie is Superman 2.
Now, Superman 3 would actually fit really well into this quiz.
It probably
Richard
would.
Richard Pryor is a bank robber. And there's a lady who's a robot.
Slow down. Don't spoil it. All right. Number 6 going to Brian?
No.
To me, I think.
Oh,
I just did.
Anthony, yeah. Sorry. Yeah. Going to Anthony, the title of the film, Mr. Spangles, and the description from IMDb, the most decorated patriot in U.S. Marine history has just been dishonorably discharged for a crime he didn't do.
No, he didn't do.
Taking on the persona of Mr. Spangles, he will exact America's righteous fury on those in the corrupt government that have wronged him, and there just might be fireworks.
Mr. Spangles.
False.
All in. You're trying to poker face me, and the only answer is all in.
The only question is,
what is the true identity of Mr. Spangles? Show yourself, Mr.
Where
Spangles.
Where is Mr. Spangles? Spangles! The only question is this just too fun to write?
Please.
Mr.
Spangles was my father.
Call me Jim.
Call me Jim Spangles.
My first name is Bo.
So we have a false and a true.
Mr. Bo Spangles.
No, I said false. I said false.
Brian.
So here's the problem. Is everything in my being says it's too perfect, it must be true. But what I'm really saying, if I reframe that, is Mikey couldn't write something this perfect, which I know is not true, so I'm going to go false as well, because I totally believe you could write something this perfect.
What a breakdown. You are correct.
It's there's going to be fireworks. It was two. Yeah. You couldn't resist. You couldn't resist.
That is correct. That is correct.
That was the one thing I was thinking of. This is too fun. Yeah. This is too fun, and he had fun doing it.
All right. I could smell your joy,
motherfucker.
Well, next one's going to you.
Let's go.
So tuck in your shirt. The next film is Kajacked. And I will spell that.
Yeah, thank you.
The film is in all uppercase K A hyphen J A C K E D exclamation point.
With a slammer.
Kajacked! Sergeant Terrell.
That's the one where Sinbad's a genie.
Excuse me.
I remember this one.
Hashtag Mandela effect.
So the description of Kajacked. Sergeant Terrell Justice wants justice, and he wants it yesterday. You dig? This is very serious. A drug kingpin is poisoning the streets of the city's hometown with his drugs. Only one cop can stop him, even if it costs him his job again.
Again.
Coming soon. For those who jive enough.
Those who what?
Jive enough.
Those who jive enough.
That's true.
Wait, is it to you?
To me, right?
Okay.
Yeah.
Kajacked. I feel like, and I'm doing this entirely because it seems unlikely that you would do two perfect Mikey fakes in a row.
You can't do that. This is where you get sucked into his game.
Hey, hold on. I think my hair is growing back on my sideburns. I'm going to say that this is another fake and that this is, he did two in a row because it felt unlikely.
Yeah.
Yeah, I'm going false on Kajacked.
So is true, false,
true,
false?
False, false.
It was fake.
Yeah!
Yeah!
Tied yet again.
Yeah. Whoa!
Grow, sideburns, grow!
Number 8, going to Brian. Your film is Steel Scorpion.
All right.
This is my favorite description of all time. After his supermodel wife is killed on their wedding day, the Steel Scorpion, but you know him better as Bam Bam Bigelow, takes to the screen as the hottest new action star since Schwarzenegger. Can Steel Scorpion save the United States from a diabolical Russian plot before the clock runs out?
All right. It's not your poker face I'm worried about. It's the co-host of 1-900 Wrestling.
Yeah, that's the thing, right? That's the thing.
I mean, God, we both got to read Justin on this one. I'm going to say it's real. It's got to be real.
I'm saying true.
Hulk Hogan was an action hero. Rowdy Roddy Piper was an action hero. Bam Bam Bigelow is really, really fat. I'm going to say this is false.
You are correct.
Damn it!
Oh! Yes!
I thought, like, because my question was, when Bam Bam Bigelow shows up, will they buy it?
No. Like,
see, that's the thing is, I have no memory of Bam Bam Bigelow.
Boy, what a screw job!
I wanted you
job.
To remember the name, not the body.
Yeah.
What a screw job that I had to go first.
Are
on
you
that
perfect
one.
Scorer right now?
No, I lost the one.
You missed one.
Okay. I missed the one. Yeah.
Okay.
Boy, and coincidentally has all his sideburns.
Oh, look at the way those sideburns and that beard connect.
We are down to the last two.
All right.
We are going to Anthony Carbonzo over here. Number nine.
Walk nine.
Like a man. As a baby, Bobo gets separated from his family during a camping trip.
Sorry, what was the name?
Bobo.
Okay.
Bobo gets separated from his family during a camping trip. After being raised by wild dogs for 20 years, Bobo is discovered by animal researcher Penny, who brings him back to the family and attempts to teach Bobo how to readjust to life with humans. While his mother is overjoyed to see him again, Bobo's older brother, Henry, is more worried about losing a share of the inheritance. As Bobo progresses with Penny's lessons, Henry plots to have him eliminated. Real or fake?
True.
True.
Not only is it true, but it starred Howie Mandel.
Yeah!
Technically, I was going to say, does not belong on this quiz because it's not really an action
movie. It's not an action movie.
Not an action movie.
IMDb said it was.
It's not action. It's a comedy. Doesn't belong on this list. yeah, he is.
Which, by the way, I don't think it's a secret anymore. But there was a time that I got talked into showing up on America's Got Talent, and I did a trick.
Jesus Christ! Another famous story.
No,
I'm Brian Brushwood. And I'm so famous.
I was also on America's Got Talent, and Howie Mandel was so into me, we had sex. It was okay. He had this thing with croutons. He wanted to put them in me. It was weird.
Okay, but it was weird because he couldn't touch the croutons or you.
No.
Okay, so
he had a tiny little salad tongue.
Caesar salad.
Yeah.
I don't know. He was like, Caesar salad. And I didn't know why.
Hold on. Trust me on this one. So I did a trick that was, it was the same gag. It was the knife gag that I did on The Tonight Show. But
Jesus Christ.
God damn it.
Oh, fuck me.
All right, fuck. Like,
I'm
sorry, Cargill wasn't
face.
Here, so now I gotta fill the void.
So anyway, Meghan McCain died when I told her this one.
No, so, I did this quiz on The Tonight Show. So
I don't think I've ever told this story publicly, by the way. So I did the
Which one, about being on The Tonight Show or about being on America's Got Talent? Because you've told them both.
I know.
One of those got
so
shown, the other did not.
I turned to Reagan and I say, can you believe it?
So I
said, Reagan, tear down that wall, and he did.
So I did the fake hand stab thing.
Yeah.
It didn't go over well because everybody actually believed I screwed up and stabbed myself with the thing, including the hosts who immediately buzzed or whatever. And so then they brought me back out, and I realized this didn't go according to plan. It's not going to work. I know how reality television works. I need to, starting now, make everything unusable. And so, in front of an audience of 600 people, I start lecturing and whatever, like long drawn out, no breaks for any edits or anything like that. And it comes down to Howie Mandel, whether or not I'm going to go on. And then he says no. And then I thought, whatever, you were Bobo.
Oh yeah,
it's a long tail on that kite, Brushwood.
Yeah, yeah. Sorry.
So anyway, here's the story about how I was on Seventh Heaven, where I had a realization that I had a sandwich for lunch.
So
at the
anyway,
end.
And I've never told this story, but I was watching Bobby's World,
which I was an actor on at the time. All right, number 10.
The last one.
Going to Jummy.
Here we go.
Number 10.
Jody.
So if I get this right, it's over.
I'm going opposite of you no matter what.
Yeah.
Just to see what's going to happen.
So this is it.
It's strategic. He's one ahead. I got to go opposite him.
The title is The Serpent and the Rainbow. And the synopsis, in 1985, after successful research in Amazonas, Dr. Dennis Allen from Harvard is invited by the president of a Boston pharmaceutics industry, Andrew Cassidy, to travel to Haiti to investigate the case of a man named Christophe that died in 1978 and has apparently returned to life. Andrew wants samples of the voodoo drug that was used in Christophe to be tested with the intention of producing a powerful anesthetic. Dr. Allen travels to meet Dr. Mariel Duchamp that is treating Christophe and arrives in Haiti in a period of revolution. Soon, Allen is threatened by the chief of the feared Tonton Macuse d'Argent Petrout. Who is a torturer and powerful witch? Alan learns that death is not the end in the beginning of his journey to hell.
True.
What's the story? Are you guys tied?
Me? No.
He's one ahead of me.
Yeah, he would tie me if we go opposite.
Well, okay.
you have no shot of winning.
Right.
You left your shot at winning on that barbershop floor.
Would I have a shot
at winning? You know who else didn't have a shot at winning? Him on America's Got Talent.
Oh, God damn it.
You got Mandel Jack.
Shit.
Jack.
You know what?
Who's Bobo now?
Still Bobo.
Hell
but it's
just
fine.
Came to Frogtown. Are we just doing callbacks? It's just callbacks.
Wait, so
if you guys are callbacks, the gates.
If you guys are both right, then he wins.
I win.
Okay, well, let me ensure that happens by saying yes, it was an HBO original.
No, it was a good movie. Vanessa Redgrave's in it. I know that it's real.
Oddly enough, it was Wes Craven's first film.
Yeah.
What?
Yeah. Yeah, it was good.
It just sat limbo and then became an HBO original in the late 80s.
I should have went with my gut. I should have went with my gut on Lyle fucking Swan.
Right?
Yay.
Tess.
Yay.
All right. Let's bring everybody a round of applause for Tess here. Tess, can you please read the final results?
Oh, the world's most gracious winner. After already saying that he won, let's take a moment, a good 3 or 4 minutes, to hear the results.
Yeah, you're already insufferable.
With your majestic sideburns.
So, Brian has 6, Tony has 8, and Jummy has a jolly score of 9.
Wow.
9 out of 10.
Nicely done.
Very good.
Nicely done, sir.
Yeah, man.
Return to form.
Dude, let's have a round of applause for Mikey Neumann.
Mikey Neumann and Mikey's Quiz.
That was a good one, man.
Always the best.
That was a solid quiz.
Hey,
solid quiz.
I just got an alert on my smartwatch that says 3 minutes ago, live night attack San Antonio, ?
Let's also take this time to remind everybody that patreon.com/nightattack is where you can support this show. How many patrons do we have out here tonight?
Dude, amazing.
Thank you guys so much. You're the ones who make this happen, of course.
You want to do plugs? Let's just go down the line. What are you most excited about that you want to share?
If you all come to the Cactus Theater Saturday at 4 p.m., doing a live version of my podcast with Jeff Cannata, We Have Concerns.
Also, everybody who's hearing this, it's already happened.
Oh, yeah. Well, I'm talking mostly these 20 people.
That's exactly. Fine. That's fine.
Anybody who's not those 20 people, check out the Star Wars show, youtube.com/StarWars. Hey, my YouTube is youtube.com/acarboni, and the podcast is wehaveconcerns.com.
Hey, real quick, will your PAX presentations be recorded and available after the fact?
Yes.
I don't know if they record Cactus. I don't know. I can never tell.
No.
All right. Wow. But we'll have it up as an episode of the show.
Okay, perfect.
I said it shitty, but no is the answer. Yeah. No is the correct answer.
All right, Mikey Neumann.
Mikey Neumann, I'm also on the Star Wars show.
It's true.
I'm all the
he
stars.
He has the wind beneath my wings
I'm
on the Star
all
Wars
the
show.
Star Wars boys.
Super famous.
Yeah,
he's actually
super.
He spends most of his days as Chopper.
He's the Force ghost that helps me make my every decision.
Little known fact, I played Anakin Skywalker's hands in The Phantom Menace. the hands.
That's good.
So you can check me out at moviesandmikey.com. Check out my show. And I am also doing a live version of my show in a better theater with more people that is being streamed live on Twitch.
Oh, I thought he meant in this right now.
I'm in the Falcon Theater, 6:30 on Saturday, but you can check me out at twitch.tv. Just go to the Penny Arcade stream or the PAX stream. I don't remember which
one. The only thing I love about you the most, Mikey, is that on your D&D character sheet, you've maxed out both anxiety and arrogance. Like, it's just both of them are at their highest.
Can I be honest?
It's nothing but preemptive attacks with this guy.
That most might be the most accurate statement anyone has ever made about me. Because, like, I'm like, yeah, I can use a sword. And they, like, look at attack, and it's, like, a question mark.
Yeah.
I don't know how to do anything.
It's like, I'm feeling uncomfortable. Sure, let's launch the bombs.
Yeah.
All of them. All the bombs at once.
Hey, man. So can we tease the fact that there's a reason that we're doing this night attack on Thursday of the week before, only 48 hours after the first night attack?
So let's say that theoretically we are going on a shoot.
Okay, all right. We're
I want to hear about any shoot you're going on, but I'm maxed out on Brian's.
All right.
So if you could tell us what's going on and Brian could keep his mouth shut,
let's just say theoretically there might have been a lot of awesome videos that came out last year in which you were able to see Brian and I do a bunch of fun adventures. We're going to be doing a lot more of those that should be coming out this year. And we're gonna
going
to go
on vacation.
Next week.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So
what if you guys made a TV show and only Brian was in it? What, how would that...
I mean, actually, you have no idea how close to factually accurate that is with my show hacking the system.
I know.
Shut up!
I'll see you guys.
This has been Night Attack. Thank you, everyone. I'm shutting it down. I'm shutting it down for Brian Brushwood!
Mikey Neumann is literally leaving. Anthony Carboni one more time. Brian Brushwood and his fucked up haircut, everybody.
Yeah.
Let's... I'm Justin Robert Young. See you next Tuesday, ladies and gentlemen.
Live forever!
I wanna hurt myself by pissing off some bees. I'm allergic to bees. Oh, Justin Robert Young, every time you go, I get so sad that I wanna drink a warm glass of Drano. Night Attack,
Night Attack,
Night Attack,
Night Attack.
Brian Sideburns.
God damn it.
Diamond Club hopes you have enjoyed this program.